Blessings and favor. This is the Apostle, Apostle Faith Percenti of Faith and Holiness Outreach and Deliverance Ministries International. And listen, I want to welcome you to be a part of our page. I want to welcome you to be a part of our ministry.
With me to the book of Judges. Judges chapter 11. Reading from verse 1. Now Jephthah, the Gileadite, was a mighty man of valor, but he was the son of a harlot. And Gilead begot Jephthah. Gilead's wife bore sons, and when his wife's sons grew up, they drove Jephthah out and said to him, "You shall have no inheritance in our father's house, for you are the son of another woman." Then Jephthah fled from his brothers and dwelt in the land of Tob. And worthless men banded together with Jephthah and went out raiding with him. It came to pass after a time that the people of Ammon made war against Israel. And so it was when the people of Ammon made war against Israel that the elders of Gilead went to get Jephthah from the land of Tob. Then they said to Jephthah, "Come and be our commander, that we may fight against the people of Ammon." So Jephthah said to the elders of Gilead, "Did you not hate me and expel me from my father's house? Why have you come to me now when you are in distress?" And the elders of Gilead said to Jephthah, "That is why we have turned again to you now, that you may go with us and fight against the people of Ammon and be our head over all the inhabitants of Gilead." So Jephthah said to the elders of Gilead, "If you take me back to fight against the people of Ammon, and the Lord delivers them to me, shall I be your head?" And the elders of Gilead said to Jephthah, "The Lord will be a witness between us. If we do not do according to your words." Then Jephthah went with the elders of Gilead, and the people made him head and commander words before the Lord in Mizpah. Bow with me, Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus, I come before you. I thank you, God, for this night. I thank you for this people. I thank you because we have entered this house asking you to bring a word. Father, we thank you now, God, that you are in this house and your presence is evident. Father, I decrease and you increase in me. Holy Spirit, I die that you may come alive. Speak through me. Speak for me. For I am nobody trying to tell everybody about somebody who can change everybody. Now let us not only be hearers of the word, but let us be doers as well. In Jesus' name, let all God's people say amen. Many of us are not familiar with Jephthah. Amen. Glory to God. But Jephthah was a judge, amen, over Israel. He became a judge over Israel and he judged for about 6 years long. Jephthah, amen, glory to God, was what you would call one of the outside children. Jephthah was one, amen, glory to God, that was you would call a bastard. Not only was he an outside child, a bastard, but his mother was considered a harlot. My God Almighty. So the Bible says that during this time, amen, Jephthah's father, Gilead, amen, married, amen, and his wife had sons. And the Bible says that when they were all grown up, these sons who feel as though they are the rightful heirs to their father's inheritance, they returned to Jephthah and they said, when daddy was alive, he had you here. When daddy was alive, he gave you bread to eat. Now daddy is dead. And so because he is dead, we ain't gonna give you nothing that should have been given to you simply because you was not born in the marriage. Hey, watch this now. So you know, what Jephthah could have done nothing except the Bible said he fled. Amen. Glory to God. And went to a low place. My God Almighty. But the Bible says that even in the low place where he was, there was some lower men than him. Some nobodies. My God Almighty. Some cast outs. Some thrown away. That gathered up a Jephthah. My God Almighty. And to make it sound real good, they became a good fighting little army. My God Almighty. What I want to say to you tonight is that some of us have been in a place where we were at the king's table. But my God Almighty, when the king died, then all of them niggas then rise up and begin to fight against you. Okay, let me put it to layman terms. You know money loved you even though you was an outside child. My God Almighty. And now that money dead and then close her eyes, you ever see how people is carry on at a funeral after you die? My God Almighty. They know mommy say when she was alive, you had to sell the house and split it equally. But now mommy dead and gone, and niggas them wanna rise up and act like mommy never recognized me. You wanna rise up and act like daddy never recognized me. Y'all can get the story in a moment. My God Almighty. But what you gotta understand is that even when you are cast out, even when you looked upon as a dog, even when they call your mommy nothing but a hoe, my God Almighty, the hand of the Lord can still be upon you. He uses whoever he chooses. I came to let you know, God says, even though you've been cast out, because as far as they're concerned, you of such a kind as this. And even those who turn their back on you gotta come back at some point. The Bible says that the Ammonites rose up against Israel. And who did they go to? The same one they rejected. Who did they go looking to? The same one that they cast out. Who did they go looking to? The one they called the black sheep. My God Almighty. And the Bible says that they have to suck it up and go down to Jephthah. And to say to Jephthah, listen, we will need you in this battle. You ever have been through a low place, but still got strength to fight against the enemy? Ask me real quick what a call it is. I have that real second for the last time. My God Almighty, you ever been to that place? My God Almighty, where you know that even though I've been rejected, there's something about me that I might not be able to touch it right now. You ever been to a place, my God, where you've been rejected, but you still know something on the inside of you, something special, something called, something chosen? My God Almighty, I don't know about you, but Chapter knew that the hand of the Lord was upon him. Chapter knew that God was going to use him. But my God, they had to run right back. Hallelujah, Jesus. My God Almighty. And so they had to go back to Jephthah. The Bible says that they went to Jephthah and they said to Jephthah, we're going to need you to fight this one for us. Jephthah said, hold on. Ain't y'all the same people that run me? Ain't y'all the same people that talked about me? Ain't you the same one that say ain't nothing good could ever come out of me? My God Almighty, have you ever been in a place where they didn't talk bad with you, but they still turn around asking for your help? You're working me, man. My God Almighty, you ever been to that place? Oh my God, I don't know about you, but I've been there many times. They didn't talk about me, scandalize me, say all manner of evil against me. I'm still the turnaround. Rejected him. God said your rejection is only for a moment. My God Almighty, your rejection is only for a moment. And I hear the Lord God say that even in this season, my God, you would have to fight for those who rejected you. That's okay. That's okay. Because I want to take a moment to dwell on what was in Jephthah's mind at that time. My God Almighty. Imagine being in the position where you didn't make a name for yourself. Because what you got to understand is Jephthah didn't just go and flee, but he began to make a name for himself. Because he was fighting against other armies and he was winning the battles. And so what happened is they began to hear about this same chapter who they then cast to the side. Chapter began to make a name for himself. You ever been in a place where everybody said you were nobody? You get when your business team start to flow, your name start to get out there, not everybody trying to act like you stay friendly. My God Almighty, but I hear the Lord say, Lord Jesus, in this season, God said, where you are, the success. success that you have, ain't nothing where I'm about to take you. It's the same enemies that rejected you, the same ones that turned their back on you. They're gonna be the same ones that I bring to you, that gonna take you to your next level. Can somebody give the Lord a prayer? Maybe because y'all ain't know the story. I know some of y'all never hear about Jephthah. So let me help you. What you gotta understand is that his father left an inheritance for him. But he was denied the inheritance. His father left something for him that could have put him in a better position. But he was denied the inheritance was left for him, and he had to go and struggle all on his own. But y'all didn't catch it. Now he didn't make a name for himself, and after he didn't make a name for himself, the same ones who denied him of his inheritance came back to him. But guess what they had to bring to the table? They had to bring the entire rulership. Y'all miss it.
Everything.
They had to make him commander and judge. Y'all miss it. You crying over that little thing you lost? You crying because your brother them in, won't you get mama them property? Put down the road. Hold on, wait a minute. You crying over 20 in it? What? Not even an acre? Because your brother them in, won't you to get that property up the road? Don't cry over that, God say. God say, I'm about to turn it around. Where you can get the property, their property, the fucking property, the rent property, and all the other properties. God ain't catching it. I guess this one for me. People. this story. There is a political drama called Designated Survivor. I don't know if y'all watched that one. It's a story that involves Thomas Kirkman. And the story goes that on the eve of the presidential address, where the president was giving his presidential address, on the eve of that, all the congressmen and all the senates and everybody had gathered together to hear the political address. But on the night of the political address by the president, there was an assassination of the entire Senate, Congress, President, Vice President, and then everybody else. But there was one man that was picked out to be the designated survivor. Now I went and I did a little research and I realized that this is an actual position in the United States of America. This is an actual existing position. The designated survivor. Now the fact is that the designated survivor don't know that they have been designated to survive. The designated survivor don't know that they've been designated to survive, and all they know is that somehow they're not invited to any of the big events, all of the big highfalutin congresses and all that. They ain't invited to none of that, and they don't understand why, because I'm a part of the political elite. Why is it I'm not getting any invitations? And why is it that I'm not a part of the special meeting? But did you say I am part of the political arena? Why am I being left out? Why am I being cut out? But here's why. Because you have been designated as the survivor. So now in this story, Thomas Kirkman, who was designated the survivor, became the president of the United States of America. He became the president, but he was the first and only unelected president. And so, of course, it brought conflict and it brought issues and drama. Can he really lead? Should he really lead? If he really lead, and how did he go? But I want to tell you tonight, there are some of us, not all of us, there are some of us that is in this house tonight that have been selected to be the designated survivor. There are some of us that are in our family that have been selected by God to bring their family into a better place. I want to use the story of Joseph, my God Almighty. And so Joseph is one that I would call the designated survivor. Why? Because Joseph, being the one that his father loved, being the one that his brothers hated, was sold into slavery, went through a whole neglection process, a rejection process, didn't understand why he was going through, what he was going through, but he understood that in the midst of it all I gotta do is continue to be connected to the source. Joseph was the designated survivor that would bring the people to a wealthy place. He was the one that God used to save the people from a famine. You gotta understand that you may be in a place where nobody wants nothing to do with you. You ain't invited to the family reunions. You ain't invited to the parties. You ain't invited to the weddings. danger. You are the designated survivor, because you are the one that will bring your family to their land of Goshen.
Yes!